Hello everyone. You want to give a better interview? Want to give a better IELTS speaking test? If yes, then look at these 10 words that I'm going to speak. In this video, I'm going to tell about 10 golden words to use to improve your English speaking score. I am Jitin Joseph. Welcome to my channel. Let's get started. So I have compiled these 10 words from my candidates and my students list, okay, who have given tests, who have given interviews, and have scored a better band. So if you are new to my channel, please subscribe it and keep watching this video till the end. So let's start with the first word. So the first word is plethora. Well, what's the meaning of plethora? A large amount of something more than needful. So plethora means something that is more than enough, okay, or a large amount. So let's make a sentence out of it. I have written one. In today's world, a student has a plethora of opportunities. So plethora means wide variety, large number of opportunities. So it is a very simple and easy word to be used. In today's world, a student has a plethora of opportunities. So let's look at the number second. The second word is supposition. Okay. Now remember, pronunciation must be correct. Your accent can change. For example, my accent is an Indian accent. Okay. A Britisher may use British, American, or Australian may use an Australian accent. Accent can be changed, pronunciation remains the same. So the word is supposition. Now what's the meaning of supposition? Supposition means an idea that a person thinks is true but which has not been shown to be true. That means a belief. Okay? Read the sentence once again, read the meaning once again. An idea that a person thinks is true but which has not been shown to be true. Okay? So it's just a general belief that is called supposition. Let's make a sentence out of it. Let me read which I have written. I have this supposition that one day my state will be crime free. Well, it's not proven right now, but I have a belief. So supposition means belief. I have this supposition that one day my state will be crime free. So let's move to the number three. So the next word is sophisticated. Remember to pronounce it correctly in your own accent. Okay. So what's the meaning of sophisticated? Showing a lot of experience of the world, or knowing about fashion and culture, or advanced / complicated. So the opposite of simple is sophisticated. Simple. Okay. That means anything that is not simple is sophisticated. Let's make a sentence out of it. Incoming of social media platforms have made our life sophisticated. Made our life sophisticated. Now, sophisticated means advanced or complicated. A second sentence. I realized that I wasn't sophisticated enough for you. I wasn't sophisticated enough. I wasn't worldly enough. Okay. The third one is flying aeroplanes is a sophisticated job. Flying aeroplanes is a sophisticated or complex, advanced, complicated. So instead of these words, we use sophisticated. It has a simple and a classic text in it. So that is why we use the word sophisticated. The fourth word is rational. Okay, a simple word to be used. Let's look at the meaning. Principles or reasons. Yes, principles or reasons. If you are going to ask a question using this word, we can ask, what's the rationale behind the study? Okay, the rationale means reason. Okay, you can use in your interviews. For example, the company manager says that we are going to design this project. What do you think? So you can say, yes, this company's project is based on the rationale of buoyancy, is based on the rationale of aerodynamics. So rational means principles. Okay, let us make another sentence. The rationale behind bringing this change is company growth. Rationale for the change is company growth. That means the reason is for company growth. So we used two sentences right now. You can use this word often in your speaking, in your writing, as well as in your reading texts also. So the fifth word I am recommending is pretentious. Pretentious means trying to appear more serious or trying to become important or exaggerated. The exaggerated word is the synonym of pretentious. Let's look at a sentence. The product appeared pretentious, so I decided to buy an alternative. Okay? The product appeared pretentious, so I decided to buy an alternative. That means it was exaggerated, false. Okay, the product was in a false advertisement, or it was over, you know, publicized. So that is why I decided. So here the pretentious word has been used. A second example, people are making the story pretentious. Now here pretentious is importance. Okay. So the people are making the story important. People are making the story more serious. That means pretentious is used here. So my sixth golden word is recall. A simple word. Let's look at the meaning. Remember something or bring from the past or to ask something to be returned. Let's look at some of the examples. Okay. The government has recalled all old currency notes. Recalled means brought back, asked to, you know, to be returned. And the second is, I can recall meeting him before. Recall meeting him means I can remember meeting him before. And the third one is, we must sometimes recall our childhood friends. Okay, we must sometimes recall our childhood friends. That means remember our childhood friends. So it's just a word to be used in place of remember. Okay, it, you know, appears more classic. For example, in your IELTS examination, if someone asks that, can you remember a place you went for a vacation, your answer, you can start it like this. Yes, I recall sometime going to this so and so place. I recall that I went to a place last year. I can recall that I visited my mom's house last year. So these are types of examples that you're going to use. Okay, a starting word, recall, very powerful, very golden. So my seventh golden word is outlook. Now, outlook, what's the meaning of that? Outlook simply means what will probably happen. It is also known as outcome or attitude or feelings about life and the world. There is a synonym for this. It is called opinion. Okay. Now let's make a sentence out of this word. We all have the same outlook regarding sports. Okay. Same outlook, same opinion. And I have a positive outlook towards this company. Very powerful word. I have a positive outlook towards this company. And a third sentence, there is a political outlook for this tragedy. As I told you, what will probably happen future. Okay. So there is a political outlook for this tragedy. Political outlook. Okay. That means future. So the eighth word is obviously. Obviously means yes, of course, surely. When you don't have a doubt, when you are 100% sure, use the word obviously. Example, there has obviously been a mistake. Okay, obviously means surely. Second example, she was obviously unwell. Obviously means she was surely unwell. So these are the two places that I have shown you to use obviously. But obviously is a word that is most commonly used. So instead of yes, you can use the word obviously. Alternative is of course. Okay. So this was my eighth golden word. So my next golden word is contentious. Now the word contentious means likely to cause argument or controversial or ceremonial. Okay, so it has both negative and positive meanings. If you look at negative meanings, they were likely to cause argument or controversial. But if you look at positive meaning, then it is a ceremonial meaning also is there. So let's see what are the applications in a sentence. This is a contentious issue. Contentious, negative issue. That means controversial or argumental. Okay. But if you look at a positive one, the royal wedding will be a contentious event. Contentious means ceremonial, celebrated event. So the royal wedding will be a contentious event. The last golden word for the day is plummeting. Okay. So plummeting is a word which has the meaning fall or drop down at high speed. For example, the Sensex plummeted more than ever. Plummeted means fell at great speed. Let's look another example. Without warning, he dropped down, plummeting with great speed. Plummeting means falling at great speed. So these were the two examples that I gave for this word. A very good word to be used in IELTS writing task 1 also. Okay. At the same time, you can use this in speaking. So these were the 10 golden words to be used in English interviews, IELTS speaking, formal conversations, to have an upper edge than others. If you have any doubt, please mention in the comment section below and don't forget to like my video. Please subscribe and put your thumb on the notification icon and do watch my videos for further and regular updates. A very big thank you for all my friends and all my candidates from whom I got and I compiled these 10 words to be used for IELTS speaking. Till my next video, bye, take care.